Hi and welcome to C# tutorial of traveling management system. So I'm going to start by resetting the whole system there. Let's say we enter someone's details there, and that will be Johnny J. Johnson. An address, let's say Johnny is from number 19 Ewa. Yes, and the postcode. That's the postcode there, and telephone number of Johnny, email address johnny@gmail. Okay, port of departure, gateway, destination. Let's go to Nigeria and single, all of the above has to be paid. Let's say Johnny is going in first class. There we go, and print our receipt. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take you guys straight into Visual C# development environment, and we'll put one of these together. So let's do that now, guys. Hi and welcome to C# tutorial of travel management system. I'm going to start by clicking on new. Now the dialog box is ready. Let's give our project a name. I'm going to call it CS_travel_management_system. Click on save. Make sure C# and Windows Forms application is selected. Okay, now that the form is ready, I'm going to select the property and define the size of this form. Let's go for 1386 by 788. That is the size of my form. The next thing I want to do is let me come up here and just add it, the following components. Let's look for panel. Should be here somewhere. Yeah, we have the panel. That's the panel there. Now let's change the properties of that panel, and where I have border style, I'm going to change that to fixed 3D. There we go. So I'm now going to copy this panel one here. That's going to be another one, and one more here. There we go. Right, now the title is in place. Let's grab a label, paste the label right in there. One label here, maybe one label, one here as well, and one right over here for time and day. So let's change the font of this middle one. I'm going to change that to bold, and let's come to maybe 48 and just increase. Oh no, I need to just to enter. Let's enter travel management system. So that's just for the title, and let's see for my time and day. This might be time. I'm gonna get rid of the content in there though, but let's come in here, just call that LBL. Should I call that time? Okay, time, LBL time. And right here, let's see, border style, I'm going to make it fix single, enable auto size, let's get rid of that, and right in here, delete the content in there. Okay, the same thing will be repeated for this one. Or we can just copy, let's copy this, yeah, and just call this one. This one is LBL time, this one will be LBL date. LBL date. There. Now the next thing I'd like to do is let's come back right here and just add a timer. Double click on the timer. Okay, now let's double click on this timer and create an object. Object date time. Let's say time I time equals date time dot now. There we go. Alright, maybe no parentheses. Okay, now I'm gonna declare another one for that'll be for my date. So right, so that's off the time, that would be LBL time dot, let's go for dot text equals I time dot, let's go for this to long time string, yeah, and that of the dates. Let's copy this and just change things around, paste it there, and this becomes date here. This is date. Get rid of this dot to time to date string. There we go. Right, so object created, that's the name of my object on here. So let me come back in here and just move this here, and let's move this up a little bit, move this right here. Okay, let's select both and just increase the font a little bit so that you guys can see it. See what's happening. Alright, we have our 12. Alright, let's run it now and see how it's gonna look like. Right there, guys. So we have the time, we have the date, but I need to move this a little bit more. So let's come in here. I think we may have to. Just. Yeah, let's get rid of these properties. Let's come right in here, just make it none. All right, okay, that's fine. Okay, the next thing is, let's run it first and see anyway. All right, that's fine. The next thing I'm gonna do is, you can always change this one to the pattern update or whatever you want. The next thing I'm gonna do is, let me just add a symbol there. So I'm gonna go to properties here. Let's go for my, or let's look for picture box. There we go, found one. Right, move that picture box here somewhere. And click on this. Let's choose a picture. I think I have a picture somewhere that I can choose here inside my icons. Let's come right here. Icon. Yeah. Let's choose one of these. Maybe this. Alright, let's see. Okay. Yeah, that looks more like it. Yeah. Alright, that's my icon there. That's my icon, the captain's icon. Okay, if I run it now, let's see. This is what we get. We have our time there, and we have dates right there. Okay, let's continue with the design of the interface. The next thing to do is, let's grab this. And in here, I'm going to enter the customer's details. So, I need. labels for that. Labels and text box. Text box. Then we need labels. Right. Let's increase both font size first. And then we take it from there. Just copy it across. I'm going to need about 6 there. Okay, so in here, we'll enter as follows. That will be, there will be first name. Surname. Okay. Now, I'll just name all of these. That might take some time, so I'm going to have to speed that up anyway. So the first one, let me just show you how it's going to be named. It's going to be txt first name. There. So I'm going to speed that up now. Okay, they all have a name now. So let's just finish up the design of the interface. Move this down here and we'll copy one here. That's going to be for my receipt. Okay, for the receipt in here, let's grab a label. Let's grab one of these. Copy, paste it right there. So that is going to be receipt. And right here, we enter a rich text box here. And one picture box underneath here. Click in there. Let me add my logo. My picture box here. Maybe one of these. Maybe this. No, the background is showing there. Let's try another one without the background. Maybe it's one of these. Okay, that's fine. So the next thing is in here, I'm gonna need some labels. I need 1, 2, and 3 labels here. Move that here. Let me add another 2. And in here, I'm gonna need 4 labels really. This one is tax, and that's total. This becomes, let's get rid of the content there, and right up here, change that to white, back color white, auto size false, and border style, make that fix symbol right there. Yeah, let's delete all of these. Now since that one is done, I might as well just copy and paste it there. Now change their names. Change this one to LBL subtotal. LBL tax and LBL. Total. That's done. Now this very one. This one will become, let's just say flight. This will be ticket. Tickets and let's let's see, we have another out there. I think maybe, yeah, that's fine for now. Okay, let's just add some buttons here. We need, let's come up here, we have a button here, change that to 18. BTN exit, and the name content will be exit. Why this one will be known as receipt, and the name will be BTN receipt. Right, this is called BTN reset. Set. Then we have BTN total. And right here, that becomes BTN total. There. Okay, we're getting somewhere. Now, right up here, I'm going to need combo box. Combo box here. One here. Let's move this in a little bit. We need a combo box. One. Change that to something a little bit readable. Let's come to the font there. I'm going to change that to about maybe 16 or 18. 16. Right. I need two more combo box. One, two. So this is going to be known as CMB departure, and this is known as, okay, that's departure. Let's copy one, two, and three. So this is departure, and the label will be known as departure. Right. And this is known, will be known as CMB destination. And the label will be known as destination. This one is known as accommodation. And the combo box will be known as CMB accommodation. Okay, we're almost there. Now we need as follows. Maybe we should use a checkbox. Yeah, we need four checkboxes here. One, let's change the properties. Right. And this one is airport tax. Is excess luggage. This is air mile. Let's say it's over 20,000. And this is insurance. That'll be travel insurance. Okay, this is how it looks like now. Now let's see. We're gonna need some other component here. Let me just copy. Let's copy these. No, let's add radio buttons. Radio buttons right there. We'll do that. Okay, we have one here. Let's change the font of that to 18 as well. Make that bold, 18. And hopefully we should be able to finish the design very soon. Right. Okay. Maybe change them to 16. 18 seems to be too large. All right. Okay, so we need two here, two radio button, and we need one each here. All right. Okay, guys, I believe I finished with the design of the interface. Let me just show it to you guys. There, I may have to move this here. Let's move that. Come in here. There somewhere. Let's just move it. And right here. That's fine. And we have the date somewhere here as well. Okay, we can then increase this very one. Let's make that about 60 now and see. Right. It's much better. So when I run it now, hopefully it should look, yeah, I think that's much better. All right, so what I'm going to do now is to start with the coding, but first thing, let me take care of this, then we'll take it from there. Let's come right down here, double click on exit. All right, there, let's declare as follows. Dialog result equals I exit, and that is my variable. So I exit equals inbuilt function message box button dot show, and just enter confirm if you want to exit. Project travel management system, then have comma there, and that would be, let's go for message box button dot yes or no. Try that again. Message box buttons dot yes no comma a message dialog, a message box icon dot question. Right, now let's use an if statement to determine the option, the selection made. If I exit equals dialog result dot yes, and we want application dot exit. There, that's the exit taken care of from here down here. Okay, the good part of it is these lines of code will actually prompt the user to confirm if they want to exit or not. So try that out. Exit, no. Exit, yes. The next thing I would like to do is, let me double click on, let's give this a name first, RP receipt. Okay, that has a name as well. So now let's double click on reset. Right in here, reset is going to be dot clear. That is for reset. Now let's reset all of the other text box. TXT address clear. TXT email clear. TXT first name. TXT is clear as well. I think this surname. TXT telephone. We get that clear. Let's now take care of the labels. LBL total dot text equals day. That is for the label. Copy that. LBL text clear. And LBL total is cleared. Now let's go to CMB dots text equals none. Okay, so I'm going to repeat the same thing for the other two. CMB equals none and CMB destination equals none as well. And now what about all of the check boxes? I think that CHK money dot checked equals false. CHK airport, yeah, then CHK luggage. Now we have CHK special need, as if passenger, special need passenger. We take care of our customers regularly, just like any other airline do. All right, we even care for special needs. That's good. So the next thing is, I believe I have cleared all of the okay I need these ones. So that would be, that has no name. Does this have a name? Yeah, just these two, no name. That is RB adult and the other one is RB child. Okay, let's reset those ones as well. RB dot think is dot check. Yeah. RB child. RB. Class RB return RB single RB standard. Yeah, so those are the lines of codes for resets taken care of. Now reset is done. All right, let's come in here. You see this very one, destination and so on. Let's come in here and enter the destination. Instead of writing the code, we can just come to the items here, click on the items and just enter the name of the departure airport, and let's say South End. And okay, that's how that one looks like. Those are the names of my airport and the text content on it. Let me just call it none. There's nothing in there. And this one as well, destination. In the case of the destination, I'm gonna speed that up as well. Okay, select item collection, and there, that is for destination. All right, so let's run it and see how it all looks like. So we can select departure point, destination, and room type. Select any of these. Okay, we need to change this. We need to change this, maybe group them separately. You see that? Alright, we're gonna group all of these separately. Alright, this works. Reset. Let's enter value in here. And reset. Yeah, that's working. Okay. So back in here. So what I'm gonna do is maybe change this to, yeah, I'm gonna have to change this as well. Yeah, let's change them all to a checkbox. Okay, add it. So delete that and delete. Just copy this. CHK adult, and the content in here becomes adult, and we then speed that up anyway. Okay, I've changed the component to checkbox here. Okay, in the case of the flight, we can only select one of those anyway, so this is fine. Now the next thing we want to do is come straight to the project. Let's add a class, or you can just click on this and just add a class. The choice is yours. There we go, and that's my class there. So I'm going to select that and just call it iTags and click on add. There, so I have my class in there. Okay, right here inside my class, I'm going to declare the following variable. So I'm going to make it public. Let's say double, and that's going to be MC tax. Let's say MC tax rate equals 0.55. Yeah, so the next thing is, let's say public double, and I'm going to give that a name. Let's say I find tax, and let's enter an argument there. Double I see amount. I see amount. Right. Okay. The next thing is, right in here, I'm going to enter the following. Let's say double, that will be double, let's say fine tax equals IC amount minus IC amount. Let's say multiply that by MC tax. touch rate. Yeah. And here we need to return a value. Return find tax right there. Okay, that is my class for the tax taken care of. Alright, now let's come into the main program here. Okay, I'm going to have to let's create another class. Let's come in here and just add a class, and I'll just call that cPrice. C_price. Right. Okay, add cPrice. And right in here, let's go for as follows. Let's say public. Let's say Nigeria, and the price of that, let's say equals 450. Right, and the next one, let's for say Canada, and that will be, let's say Canada T. Let's call T equals 320. That would be double, really. Equals 320. So I'm just going to now speed that up. Okay, right here I have the price for all of the flight in here inside the class known as cPrice. Right. Okay, now that that is ready, let's come back in here. So we have two classes, the class for tax and the class for the price. So take a good look at the price again. Take it down. And there. Okay, back in here, inside total, double click on your total. And the next thing is we have to create, let's create two, we need to create two objects. Let's say travel price. Travel price equals new cPrice. Let's enter parentheses here. Okay, the next one is going to be iTax. So let's call it travel tax. Travel airport tax, really. Air tax equals new iTax. Parentheses. There we go. All right. Now we have both objects that actually make reference to price and tax. Now the next thing we want to do is, let's see in here, the first item on the list, that doesn't matter anyway, doesn't really mean, let's come in here and just write, I'm going to copy this. So let's go back in here, and we're going to use an if statement. If CMB destination dot tax equals that, and I want the following to happen. If it's that, what do we want? Okay, before we can do anything, let's create an array here, double. We can just call that travel cost. Travel cost equals new double. Because I don't know how many, let me just put 20 for now. And I'm going to declare another one for my tax itself. So tax, that'll become tax cost, right? Let's leave them like that. Now the first thing I like to do is, let's say travel cost zero. Travel cost zero, because arrays always starts from zero, equals this travel price dot, the first one is Canada Toronto, there, close that. Now we have the travel cost. What about tax? So in the case of tax, we now want tax cost zero equals, that would be air tax, this very one, dot I5 tax, and enter that in parentheses. So what will be in the parentheses is this, and close that. So that is for Toronto. Let's see if that is gonna work. So the next thing is, we now need to assign everything into an object. For assigning it into an object, maybe I should declare one. Let's say double equals total. Let's say total. And in here, I'm gonna have to add those two. Total equals this very one here, plus this, that will give me the total. Now we now need to create string, that's a string subtotal, subtotal equals what? Let's say string dot format, and what we are formatting. Okay, there's no need declaring another one. I'm gonna get rid of this. Let's just say LBL subtotal dot text equals string dot format, and that will be this very one, that's for subtotal. There, close that. All right, that is for subtotal. The next one is going to be LBL tax, tax dot text equals this, and another one is going to be LBL total. And paste all of that in there, then change it around. This is going to be for tax there, why this is going to be for total right there. So if Canada is selected, this is what I want you to do. Now let's see, let's try it out. I might not need this anymore, but let's try it out. See, okay, let's select, yeah, Canada, and let's click on that. All right, that works the way I want, and you add this and get this. The tax rate seems to be too high though. All right, that is fine. Let's click on reset. There, it's working how we want. That's good. Now let's come in here. We can always, no, let's go back in here. Supposing it's not Canada. Copy all of this. Paste that in there. Let's say it's not. Select this item. And the item, I have to get it right. So that's why I'm copying it from here. And in here, if it's not Toronto, if it's a tower, then that changes. Alright. Let's go inside the tags. I think that is a bit too much. Run it now and see what's going to happen. Let's say we have Toronto. And let's say if we have, this is still too much. Let's say if we have a tower. Alright. That is fine. That is fine. Okay. One thing I need to do is just to have a look at these tags. I think there's something is too high. Alright. Okay. Let's copy more. And let's say we have another country there. Let's go for Nigeria now. Item. Copy. Come right in here. And paste that in here. And this will become Nigeria. Let's see. N for Nigeria. Right, so that takes care of that as well. Okay, if I run it now, let's see. Let's select Nigeria in there. What else do we need? I think that might be. Okay, let's reduce all that. I think it's not recognizing it. Take all of this off. Copy that. And back in here. Let's try that again. Okay, that is much better. Right. And the tax rate might be too high. I don't like that. Let's go back in here. We're gonna have to reduce this thing more. Yeah. Okay. Take care of that later on anyway. But let's just speed up the whole process of the anything that need modifying. No, modifying will be taken care of later on anyway. Alright. Let's continue. The next one, let's go back in there. I'm just gonna copy and paste as usual. Copy. There's going to be some other modification. This will be the fourth one or so. 1, 2, 3, 4, yeah. And just select that item, select, and let's go for Norway. Norway right there, paste Norway in there, and here change dot n Norway. There we go. Okay, That's fine. Try it no way as well. That's good. Alright. It's fine. Okay, I think I've figured out what the problem might be with this tag. So let me close this and just come here. One thing is I'm going to change this to 0.75 and right in here. Okay, let's see. Okay, I think that should, that's fine now. Let me run it since I've changed the percentage for the tags. Let's see, select anyone and just, yeah, that's much better now. That is fine. Let's try out Nigeria. Okay, that's fine. Now reset. Alright, so I'm just gonna add this into it and we can call it the end of the program. So let me come in here. And here I'm gonna add those ones. So let's say plus. Let's take it up. Just do one or two of it and that will be all. Travel price dot CHK. It's not CHK really. I think it's got to do with the flight. No, not the flight. Let's come in here and check out the price. Okay, we want all of these airport tax and so on, right? Come right there. So that becomes airport tax. What else do we need to add? The mileage. That is travel. Look, that of mileage. And we also have insurance and excess luggage. So we need to add all of those to it. Where is it? Dot. And one more. Excess luggage. Okay, that is taken care of. Alright, that's fine. Maybe we should break it into two. Alright, that is okay. I'm just gonna copy it for the rest anyway. Repeat the same thing. Well, that is Canadian tea already. Let's grab it from here down. Alright, so that is it guys. As you can see, it's the same lines of code, so that shouldn't be of any problem to you guys to get sorted. Okay, so let's run it again. And maybe those ones we can just leave them as default. These ones we have to make sure they are checked. Right, click on that. There we go. Okay, so all you just need to do is enter the customer's details. Name, address, town, lane, postcode, telephone number, email address. There. And destination, select that, double rooms, and any of these, and we click on receipt. So it's the receipt that is left for us to take care of. So what I'll do is, let's take care of the receipt, but before that, okay, let's go on to the form itself and double click on form using form load. So select the following. I think that is airport tax dot checked. We'll make that true as the default equals true. And we also have, I think it's air mile, make that true as well. CHK, gonna be excess luggage dot check equals true, and CHK, think there is insurance dot checked. True as well. All right, so those would be that would be the default for this very checkbox here. Now the next thing is we want to double click on the receipt. Okay, I'm going to exit out and enter some lines of codes here, and also when I reset this, I want this to be on. I want them all checked. So let's exit. I'm right in here. First of all, let's come straight in here, and I want this to be true, or yeah, I can just comment it all out or just make it true, one of those. Okay, let's just make it true. So this other one, that'll be true as well, and this will be true, and finally this. The next thing is, with the total itself, I need to complete the rest of the destination. So I'm going to copy that, paste that in there. And this very destination, let's look for the destination here. That is, I think we have layers. Okay, let's go for India. Alright, so come back in here and just enter India here. That's India done. And we also need to change that to the right price. Okay, so let's copy India. Paste three of those. So let's find out the other names. Come in here. After India, we have Rome, Italy. Copy that. Come right in here. And this is it. There, then here will be Italy as well. Dot, yeah. after Italy, we have, let me delete this, let's just make it Dallas, USA Dallas. Yeah, that's fine. Go back in here. So this will be USA Dallas. And this will be dot D Dallas there. And the other one, that's Alaska actually. Let's come in here and copy that. So trip to Alaska. Right there. There guys. All of those variables, you find them inside the class here. That's where you have all the price. Those are the price I'm actually calling. All right, so that's done. The next thing I'd like to do is, this is not all finished yet, so you guys can complete the rest. It's just very, I think I've done about 8 or 9 of it. All right, the next thing is, let's take care of this. So I'm going to double click on reset and just enter the following. Okay, right here, I've declared a random integer. Okay, that will be for my reference. Then the names of every single component, this very one here. First name, surname, and so on. That is them right here. Okay. You don't have to enter them as string. You can always just copy this and paste it here if you want. It's still the same thing. So if I copy this and paste it all there, I can delete this other one though. Okay, let's go for address. Postcode. Then after the postcode telephone, copy and paste that. Okay, in the case of the email, that's not there. This one is fine. So I want to delete all of these. I don't need them anymore. They're gone. And even these tags. Okay, let's paste this there. Because it's all string, so it should still work. Alright, that means I don't need any of this declaration that I made earlier. So that will even make life easy for you guys. Alright, that's my receipt there. Receipt now. So let's run it and see. From year to year, the receipt. Let's run it. Okay, now let's enter details in there. Let's say that is Steve Daly. An address, let's say number 12. Then postcode QW33, telephone number, email address steve@gmail.com. Okay, now departure point, destination, let's say Steve is off to Alaska, and single, he has to peel the following. Economy is an adult. Click on total. Reset. There we go, guys. You can see the date here. It's right in here. And the time. I think this time maybe we should. Okay, that's the right time the ticket was printed. Right, so that's fine the way it is. Okay guys, so with that, I'm gonna call it the end of this tutorial. I suppose you guys enjoyed. So with that, I'll say bye for now. And you all have a nice day now.